Hey, as you can read, this is my team and me. And this talk is a little bit of a thanks to the type level project. And I want to describe how well we could use it. So this is us, two computer scientists and two non-computer scientists building a project with type level. What am I going to talk about? I'll explain a little bit what the project we did, and in the second part I'll explain how the all the type level projects helped us. I thought I have to explain a lot of things, but the other speakers explained the concepts so well I don't have to talk about it anymore. So it didn't even only help with the project, but also with the talk. So let's talk about the project a little bit. It's called CaptAstra. And the idea was to address one problem in microscopy. It's first of all, nobody is interested in the beautiful pictures. You can usually see it in the magazines or publications or for the any presentation, but in reality, nobody cares about them. They want to know, is it cancer? Is it not cancer? Will the machine break? Will it not break? So there are a lot of people developing machine learning algorithms or statistics or whatever to come up with a solution that gets an input of an image and outputs a value true or false or something like that. Well, the problem is these applications are very specialized usually. And there's only one guy writing this for this type of cancer, an algorithm that decides if yes or no. And so he only writes in what he's comfortable with. So a lot of guys use Fiji, which is Java based, but a lot of other guys use other things like R or even MATLAB. So this project was all about wrapping these little algorithms that are produced by the community into Docker containers and give the users make them available on a platform and give a way to combine these little steps into one big workflow that you can have a microscope and still and in the end get an answer. So how did type level help us? We didn't have to start from zero for a lot of things that have to happen. So we could come up with a prototype in 6 weeks and then get the funding for the project to make it happen. So I'm non-academic, so this is the level of architecture diagrams I'm showing. We have three components. The first one is an AST. Then we have something that glues everything together. And at the end, we have something that runs it. It's all very German things for the inside shocks, Lars mentioned. In our case, it's very much more simple. We have a set of Docker containers that are combined in a special way. We have some marshalling of them into things that can be understood by the individual container. And then we have something that runs them afterwards. So how did the type level project help, and how did the previous speakers help me? Because about the free, I don't have to talk anymore. You know what it's for. I even added, I removed a lot of slides and added this one just to show you. We did it like it was presented. So how did it help? Using the free, we could get the compilation of the whole thing at, and immediate user feedback about the correctness of the workflows the user submitted. So this was critical because we want to run it afterwards in the cloud. We want to know it's correct when the user submits it and compile it in a sense and not get the errors when the user tries to run it. Another thing we used from CATS directly was the state. So we could implement something like the time machine in Apple, it's called, like you can get back to where an error happened or something was and fix something and then go forward again with the rest of the thing. In the glue department, we used Shapeless. If you have any doubts if it was really useful, yes, and it's really great and useful, because every of these containers at the end of the branches, they produce something, and we want to make sure it's the thing they promised to produce. So we have introduced a sealed type hierarchy, which only and every container has to produce one of these. So we could type check the whole program and automatically generate the instances of the Java types at the value level during the execution. And the last part is where Monix comes into the play and cancelability and other stuff, like if you want to run something from somebody else, you don't want to allow it to run infinitely, but you want to able to be to cancel it or to provide a fallback value and all this stuff. If we would have had to write it ourselves, we I wouldn't be standing here, but the project would have been canceled. So everything that's really needed to be there to provide something, to calculate something in the cloud, relied heavily on having this Monix and the task with all these functionalities. Wrapping it all together, which was pretty fast now, not only in reality, but also in the talk, because this was all explained. We will be able to give a prototype and a framework how things work. Our team is working not in a production unit, but in a digital transformation unit. So all this, I cannot answer you if it's really in the product still. If you have questions in that direction, please go to the website in the second slide, and there's a contact who can answer your questions. So we could provide a prototype and a set of methods and give it to our developers and let them happen it. One another thing, really cool thing we just tried out for ourselves is all this stuff I described, we could just compile to Scala.js, and we tried it ourselves to evaluate how to work with it. And we were able to get our machine learners to make an algorithm that checks if somebody cleaned the coffee machine after they made a coffee and let it run on a Raspberry Pi on a single thread, and then it calls out to TensorFlow in the cloud, and still looks very small, like management compatible small in a Raspberry Pi, but offers a lot of functionality and ran correct for some time before we had to remove it. So, to wrap it up, what were my personal highlights working with the type level things? We were two computer scientists and two non-computer scientists, and still we were able to communicate on a very high level and find the implementation. So if we understood the concept together, we could split up the work and everybody could contribute. And the second most important one to me were the Scala exercises, where I could check if everybody really had understood the concept or the implementation we were talking about. Yeah, that's it for my thank you.